This video is about the Bucyrus Erie Model 10B. I have two examples here of the 10B, and I'm going to give you some history on these machines, and then we'll go in the cab and I'll explain the controls and how the machine operates. Now, Bucyrus manufactured the 10B from 1934 to about 1959. Records indicate they produced 2,428 machines during this time, which is just under about 100 a year. Now, the 10B is a 3/8 yard capacity machine. Depending on the type of boom and counterweight configuration, these machines weighed from just over 16,000 pounds on an early model to just under 20,000 pounds on a later model. Now, these were available with gasoline, diesel, or electric motors in them. The shovel here is a 1937 with a Hercules six-cylinder gas engine. Now, this one engine has water damage on it, so I'm either going to be looking to replace it or possibly find the parts to get it repaired. If anybody knows a good parts source for Hercules, you can let me know. Now, this other machine is a 1951 with Buta HP 260 six-cylinder gas engine. This machine has the standard 28-foot channel boom on it. Bucyrus also offered a 5-foot extension for this boom for a maximum length of 33 feet or a shorter boom of 25 feet. Now, for this machine, I have two dragline buckets, clamshell bucket, a shovel front, and the cable backhoe front, which Bucyrus referred to as the drag shovel. Now, these particular machines came from northern Minnesota, where they were used for construction and the owner had a gravel pit. He had them for at least 40 years, and they had been for sale for a couple of years. And if I didn't buy them, they were probably going to go to the scrapyard. Now, the biggest hurdle, of course, was getting them shipped over 600 miles from Minnesota down to Indiana. But I did happen to contact Kircher Transport up in Minnesota, and they put together a really great package for me, getting both these machines hauled down here at a really good price. Now, let's climb up in the cab. I'll explain the controls on the machine and how they operate. Behind the operator's seat, we have the control panel. It's very basic. Got your choke, your on-off switch, throttle, starter button, and a couple of gauges. I'm not going to start the machine up today because I don't want to be talking over the noise. And it's really hard to hold the camera with one hand and actually try to operate any of the controls with one hand. Now, real quick here, I'll say what all the levers are and then I'll go back and explain them. This one on the outside here is the brake lock. This lever is your main clutch. We got your hoist or rear drum, dipper trip. This is your drag. Our front drum. This is a swing and propel lever. This lever here is the high speed propel. This machine is a two-speed, has a low gear and a high gear. That's what this is for. This lever down front here is the house lock. This is your boom control right here. Right here is the steering crank. And this lever down here next to the seat is the selector for either swinging or propelling. Now, one of the things you need to understand about a cable excavator like this is that it's really only capable of lifting the bucket or pulling the bucket towards the machine. Everything else is just done by gravity. Now, starting with the controls. The brake lock down here is used to lock the two brake pedals, and the two brake pedals are for the front and rear drums. And you would do that if you were propelling the machine and you wanted to keep the bucket in the raised position without having to stand on the brake pedals. You would push the pedal down, pull the lever back, it locks, and that'll keep your bucket in the raised position. That'll keep your drums locked. That will keep any cable from being released from the drums. Now this lever here is the main clutch. That's the lever that attaches the motor to the rest of the machinery. When you pull back on the lever, it engages the main clutch, which starts the two shafts here that the drums are mounted on. It starts them turning. Like I said, it's sort of like putting your car into gear, which connects the motor with the drive wheels on the automobile. Your next lever here, this is your rear drum. It's the hoist for the bucket. And you would push forward on this, and it engages a clutch, and it'll start raising the bucket. Now, when you get the bucket to the desired height, if you let off the clutch, it'll simply drop back to the ground. So you have a brake pedal down here. When you get the bucket where you want it, you start letting off the lever. You press down on this pedal, and it holds it in position. To lower the bucket back down, it's simply gravity. You release the brake pedal, and the bucket will come back down. This next lever here is for the dipper trip, should that be set up as a shovel. There's a clutch here, this one right here behind the seat, that for the cable for the dipper trip, this clutch spins and it keeps the cable tight. And when you push this lever in front here, it puts additional pressure on the clutch and it gives the cable a pull, and then that will release the dipper and dump the bucket. The taut lever in the middle here is for the drag that operates the front drum. And you would push this lever forward and it engages the drum and it'll start pulling the bucket towards the machine. When you get the bucket where you would want it, you would raise it up with this with the hoist lever here, and you would use the two brake pedals to hold it in position. Now when you see guys casting out the bucket, one of the ways they do that is by using the drag line here to pull the bucket in towards the machine, and then when you release the brake pedal quickly, it pays out the cable and the bucket will be cast out. This lever here is the swing and propel lever. Now on a Bucyrus machine, at least these smaller ones, you can either be propelling the machine or you can be operating it and swinging the house and the boom, but you cannot do both at the same time. There is a selector lever next to the seat here, and in the rear position it is in swing mode. It also has a neutral, and then in the front position it's in propel mode. So depending on what mode you have it in, you would push the lever forward or backwards to swing the machine, or you would push it forward to go forward and pull back on it to go backwards. Now this next lever here is the high speed propel. The 10B has two speeds, a low and a high. I've never used this lever. I've been told you probably don't want to use it. My understanding is the machine moves pretty fast, and since this machine is over 50 years old, you probably just end up leaving a trail of broken parts behind you. Now this lever down here, this is the house lock. This is what prevents the machine from swinging from side to side. If you're going to propel the machine, you have to pull back on that lever, and that locks the house from swinging. And it also engages a small steering clutch, which is down here at the bottom of this chain where the sprocket is. So it's a safety feature that in order to steer the machine, you have to have the house locked. You might not think so, but as soon as you start propelling this machine, if the house is not locked, it will start to turn. These machines, as long as they're operating properly, they pivot very easily. And once it starts spinning and you are in propel mode, there's really no way to stop it from spinning. You could reach down there and you could grab that house lock and pull it, but if it's spinning too fast or there's too much weight out on the end of the boom, you could break the mechanism or break the swing gear. So before you propel the machine, you always pull back on that, engages your steering clutch, and keeps it from swinging. Now this lever over here is for the boom control. On this machine, the boom is only under power when you are raising it. It gets lowered by gravity. So in order to raise the boom, it's not too bad. You disengage the main clutch and you grab this lever and you pull it over, and then when you re-engage the main clutch, it'll start turning the small drum down here and it'll start raising the boom. Now lowering it's a little more difficult. The boom actually lowers under gravity on this machine, and there's several things you have to do. When you engage, pull this lever over to engage the boom control mechanism, you'll have to reach over here and you will have to pull on the main clutch and raise the boom slightly to get it off of, there's a little locking mechanism, a little paw here that holds the boom from going down. And so you raise the boom slightly, you have to release this little paw here, and then with the boom lever, if you start to push forward, it will start to release the brake and the boom will start down by gravity. It almost takes three hands to do this. It is pretty difficult. You do get used to it. The boom, being that it's reeved four part with the cables, which you can see right outside the window here, it doesn't go down real fast, so it usually won't get away from you. The last control I'd like to explain here is the steering on the 10B, which is done by this crank, and you can see the sprocket and the chain, and it goes down to another sprocket down by the floor. Now the way the 10B steers, it has two sets of clutches, disc clutches that are very similar to those on a motorcycle. And when you start turning this crank, it'll start to disengage the clutches. And when it does that, of course, it disengages the power to the track. If you turn it forward, it's for one direction. If you turn the crank rearward, it's for the other direction. And if you continue turning that crank, there is two sets of brakes down there, band brakes, and it will gradually apply those brakes. So this way, when you're running this machine, when you're propelling it, you can actually steer the machine while it's being propelled by turning this crank right here. Now that is something that you cannot do on a lot of other Bucyrus machines, including the 22B. In order to steer that machine, you actually have to stop, you have to set the clutches, then you start to propel again, and the machine will pivot in one place, and you get it pointed where you want it, and you stop again, you release the clutches, and then you start propelling again. The 10B is a little different. It is, when they say it can be steered like a tractor, what they mean is that you can steer it while you're propelling it. And like I said, that is something that cannot be done on a lot of the other Bucyrus machines. Anyways, that is about it for the controls on this machine. I hope I've done a good job of answering people's questions on how this machine actually works. And I'd just like to say thanks to the guys who kept these machines, a father and son that kept these all these years, that really didn't want to see them go to scrap, and all the guys at Kircher Transport that helped me get them down here, my family and friends that have helped me out, my wife for understanding, and thanks for watching the video.